Welcome back to our Proactive London studio, where I'm talking to Sam Garrett. He's the CEO of Great Southern Copper. Firstly, great to have you on the line, Sam. And secondly, you've just got back from Chile, where there's been some exciting news. Get us up to speed.
Thanks, Tom. Yes, just back from Chile, being on site. Everyone's very excited there, as we all are elsewhere within the company. We're about to start, or we're planning to start, our drilling at Especularita imminently. We're just sort of waiting for the final environmental and archaeological reports to be submitted. And once that's done, we've pretty much got the go-ahead. So that's drilling at the Abundante and Terra Sita prospects, where we're targeting high-grade copper and high-grade gold mineralization. So we're all very excited to get that started.
I'm sure. Just for those people not already very familiar with the story, just why is that such a significant step, do you think, Sam?
Well, it's the first drilling on this project, and the first drilling that we know of on these specific targets. They've never been drilled before, and they are, well, at least the Terra Sita one is an extensive target. So this is scout type drilling to give us an understanding of what it is the system looks like, and then we'll take it from there. But yeah, it's a very exciting time and nervous time, of course.
Well, absolutely. A pivotal moment. We really appreciate you taking the time to talk to us about it. There was some other news as well. You're adding lithium to your portfolio.
Indeed, we are, Tom. It's an opportunity that we have been looking for some time. You know, we've said one of our corporate objectives over the last 2 years has been to add a third project to our portfolio. We've had an extensive look at projects all over Chile, but this one is too good to pass up. It offers us a toehold in the lithium exploration space, which is becoming very competitive in Chile and elsewhere around the world, obviously. But in Chile, things are definitely hotting up, and it's nice to have a large beachhead there in the Salar de Atacama. Remembering, of course, these are applications. It's a 23,500 hectare application across various projects around the Atacama Salar. We're looking forward. You know, we're very excited about it. It's a big step for us, but it's not something that's going to distract us at all from our copper gold activities. It's just going to be another opportunity. It gives us and our shareholders some optionality in commodities to explore for. And of course, these days, you know, lithium and copper, they aren't they're sort of talked about in the same breath in the pivot to clean energy. So it's the right thing to be doing.
And so am I right in saying that there's a bit of a push in Chile at the moment to try and get their lithium crown back? Because I know that a lot of people have been saying that they dropped off the number one spot in terms of global production. Does that represent a bit of a tailwind for your efforts, do you think?
I think it does. And it certainly won't hurt us. Chile is under some pressure to, internally as well as externally, to lift its lithium production. Obviously, Australia has surpassed Chile in recent years. In Australia, obviously, they're producing lithium from hard rock spodumene type deposits. So we're talking about two different types of lithium. But the lithium reserves, as I understand it, in Chile are larger than those currently known in Australia. These things always change over time, but that's what I understand is the case today. They are keen to ramp up production.
Just one final question from me, Sam. Give us a sense of the timeline with that drilling campaign you mentioned earlier.
We've got our drill holes prepared. That's what I was there in Chile for, to make sure everything looks tickety-boo. But we're just waiting on these required permitting steps that you have to go through, which is as it should be. And as soon as we've got those in, then we will be ready to go. We've approached the contractors. We've got everything lined up. We're just waiting for final approvals. And once we have that, we're going to be RC drilling. These are scout holes. So the drill holes themselves won't take very long to complete. I would suspect it'll all be over and done with within a month. And then depending on, we're sort of at the mercy of labs after that. But I would suspect all things going well, and we know they never do, 4 to 6 weeks after that. So we're looking at sort of 2 to 3 months for results, assuming we get approval to drill sort of within a month.
All right then, Sam. Well, it's been a pleasure getting your thoughts. Thank you very much indeed for your time, and best of luck with it all.
Thanks, Tom. Very nice to talk to you.